Hey everyone, I'm Shaylin here with Reedsy, and today I'm going to be sharing 9 writing podcasts that you can listen to. There's more than 9 out there. There are so many podcasts, but here are 9 good ones that I would recommend next time you're on your commute and you feel like you just want to hear some people chat about writing. Here are some podcasts you can check out. First of all, I wanted to start with one of my personal favorites, and it's Lit Mag Love, which runs out of Room Magazine, which is a Canadian literary journal. This magazine is focused around the literary magazine world and publishing your poems or short stories or creative nonfiction. In every episode, the host, Rachel Thompson, interviews a different editor from a different magazine. The discussions are varied, but they chat about the editor's personal writing projects, the magazine, what the magazine is looking for, happenings in the literary world. If you're currently aiming to publish in magazines, this podcast is invaluable. It has so much great information. First of all, just debunking the realities of what the submission and acceptance process looks like from an editor's point of view, and also giving you really concrete ideas of what different editors at different magazines might be looking for. Not to mention, I find the discussion is always really mellow but really interesting. It's kind of just a nice, relaxing listen, in my opinion. There is a focus on Canadian magazines because it is run by a Canadian journal, so a lot of the editors are from Canadian magazines, but that's not exclusive. There are some American editors that I've seen on there, so it's not exclusive to just the Canadian literary world, which is a relatively niche bubble. And of course, the information that they talk about in terms of submission is pretty much applicable across the board. Number 2 is the Verses podcast, hosted by Franny Choi and Dennis Smith. If you're interested in poetry, Verses might be the podcast for you. Each episode features an interview with a different poet where they chat about the poet's work and also usually do a reading. The banter from the hosts is always really fun and interesting, and the guests are also always really interesting to hear from as well, especially since poetry is a more abstract medium. If you're a reader of poetry, it can be really nice to then hear the author's take on the work after you've read it to get some perspective about what they were intending, since it is a form that has so much room for interpretation. Next up is probably one of the most well-loved writing podcasts across the board, and it is Writing Excuses. Writing Excuses is concise, well-loved, and long-running. The episodes are only 15 minutes, so ideal if you're just on a quick walk somewhere, you have a really short commute. I need to wash dishes, just pop in an episode of Writing Excuses and it will be the perfect amount of time. In each season, the hosts, which include best-selling fantasy author Brandon Sanderson, break down a different topic. There are also transcripts of the podcast available, which is super useful if you want to double check anything later or save anything for your notes or anything like that. So this is all fun, craft, publishing, poetry, you know, good stuff, but if you want to learn about the nuts and bolts of writing, then I would recommend Grammar Girl. Grammar might not seem like the most engaging topic to focus a podcast around, but it is a pretty darn important skill for writers, so if you feel like it's something you need to brush up on, listening to a podcast on the topic is probably going to be a lot more entertaining and a bit more digestible than, you know, reading through a textbook on it, which is probably going to be a little dry. And plus, then you can be one of those fun or annoying, depending on perspective, people who corrects people's grammar all the time. If you're interested in kind of just like the classic interview style podcast, then I would recommend checking out Writers on Writing with host Barbara DeMarco Barrett. In each episode, she interviews a different author, agent, or editor, including some fairly high-profile guests like Leanne Moriarty. Other guests have included screenwriters, playwrights, film and TV producers, publishers, and book publicists. So if you want to learn about writing and publishing, this is a great podcast to basically kind of cover a huge general range of topics from people who know it best. Next up is the New Yorker podcast. If you want to gain some credibility points with your local MFA students, or just listen to people read stories to you, this might be the podcast for you. This podcast features authors who are currently publishing, reading stories from the magazine's backlog, and then discussing them. So unlike other podcasts where they might directly talk about the craft of writing, this one is more of just a chat where an author discusses a story that they like, or if you just want someone to read a story to you while you're walking to the grocery store, that's also pretty nice. And finally, last but not least, in fact, maybe even you could say saving the best for last, Bestseller by Reedsy. Did you know that we have a podcast? Because we have a podcast. If you are interested in self-publishing or indie publishing, do we have the podcast for you. Bestseller is all about demystifying the self-publishing process. Episodes are almost all under half an hour, a lot of them around the 20-minute mark. The first season follows self-published author Shaz Kang's journey to becoming a self-published author. So if you're interested in following real journeys from real self-published authors, learning about the self-publishing process, then I recommend you check this one out. Not just saying it's good because we made it. It is actually like really good. I really like the podcast. So those are my podcast recommendations. What is your favorite podcast, writing or otherwise? Thank you so much for watching, and remember to subscribe for new writing, editing, publishing, and apparently podcasting videos every Tuesday and Friday. Until next time.